As SAP celebrates its 50-year anniversary, we invite you to join us by creating a fun video to let us know what you love the most about ABAP. It's very simple. Send us a short self-recorded video, 30 seconds, on what you love about ABAP by August 12, 2022. Your submission will be a part of a short video about the history of ABAP in context of the past 50 years of SAP and how ABAP changed our lives as developers. The goal of the video is to focus on the impact ABAP had on us as individuals and show the advantages for the new developer generation to get started. Read the blog post in the link below for more information on video guidelines and submission link. We're looking forward to seeing all of your submissions.
Release 2207 of SAP Business Application Studio is available now. This new release has plenty of new features. Here are some of the highlights. There's a new booster on SAP Business Technology Platform. Get started with SAP Business Application Studio. We mentioned this in last week's news episode. There's a closer link to the SAP API Business Hub in that the API Hub Enterprise Service Provider is integrated into the Service Center. And talking of integration, the SAP Continuous Integration and Delivery Service is integrated too in a new view or perspective that lets you look at and manage CI/CD pipeline jobs. Check out the details for these features and lots more in Mayara's blog post.
SAP Analytics Cloud Release 2216 is available for fast-track customers and for users of trial and guided experience instances. Now, while exporting a package or editing an existing package, you can choose to include or exclude object dependencies. During the first transport, you normally would like to transport objects with all their dependencies. During subsequent transports, you want to transport only delta changes, and this enhancement allows you to include objects, but not their dependencies. As well, this 2216 release includes a new set of features in the optimized story experience. For example, in the optimized view mode, a new active viewport rendering feature only renders objects that are visible on screen and will pause all objects outside the viewport until the user scrolls to another area of the story. It enables SAP Analytics Cloud to provide information as quickly as possible while enabling the viewer to execute multiple subsequent interactions. Obviously, as a story designer, you can set default rendering experience by yourself.
iRPA, that's robotic process automation for building those desktop bots that do your work for you, has a new release. Here are a few of the features. First, iRPA has a new SDK for Google Workspace apps, meaning you can create automations that open and get information from apps like Gmail or Google Sheets or Google Drive. Note that this SDK is still in beta, and so you'll have to request to be part of the beta program. Second, SAP Process Automation, which includes iRPA, now has import and export, an always vital feature so that you can share your projects, including your automation projects, with your colleagues or migrate projects to and from different tenants. And third, the desktop agent is getting a major overhaul. The new version will be much easier to install and to get updates for. It also has histories and traces of the bots that run on your desktop. And also the home screen has been significantly redesigned to include the current version, the current project, the current tenant, and other information. Remember that some of you, or most of you, have iRPA as part of SAP Process Automation. Some of you may be running it standalone with a different service plan. Depending on what service plan you have, the timing of the release of these features may vary, but should be within the next few weeks. All of the features are described in Ashina Mahajan's new blog, where she also describes how you can participate in the beta programs for Google SDK and the new desktop agent. A link to her blog is in the description.